Hi, in this video, I want to show you how you can create drop caps in Affinity Publisher. So a drop cap is when the first character or occasionally the first word of a paragraph or a chapter is larger than the rest. So this is actually very easy to create. I've got a text box with some text here. Cursor is just anywhere in the text box. And I want to find the paragraph window. So I'm going to drag it out so we can see it. If you're not seeing or finding the paragraph window, you can go to View, Studio, and then just make sure that paragraph has a check mark next to it. So in paragraph, you've got a lot of different things you can adjust. We want to look for the one that says drop caps and expand that out. And then all we need to do is check enabled, and voila, there's our drop cap. Now some adjustments that we can make, we can adjust how big that is in how many lines it's going to cover. So right now the height in lines is 4, which means we've got 4 lines of text here. I think 2 is pretty good. So we'll leave it there. And then characters, you can leave it to be automatically choosing how many characters, which is usually going to be 1. Or if I unclick it, I can adjust. So if I wanted the whole first word, I'd need 4 characters because the word this is 4 letters. Let's keep it on just the first letter. Distance to text. So watch as I click this. This will show you how far away that first letter is relative to the rest of your text. So you can make it further away or closer by adjusting up and down. Align left edge. So this text is sort of centered right now. You can see that the bounding box of our text box is off to the left a bit. So watch this area carefully as I click align left edge on. It moved everything right to the left edge of this bounding box. Scale for descenders just makes adjustments to account for letters that have descenders, like a G, where the tail goes below the line. So a Y also has a descender. So just make some auto adjustments for that. And then under style, you can have no style. So this is just a plain letter T, or if I wanted to italicize it or bold it or italicize and bold it, I could do that. Let's stick with bold for this. So those are the adjustments you can make, and that's how easy it is to create a drop cap. Just look for the paragraph window and scroll down to drop caps and enable it. Thanks for watching.